Are you tired of receiving those annoying spam emails in Elementor? Well, if this is the case, then this video is for you, as we will share multiple ways to prevent spam from coming in via your Elementor forms. Well, hello everyone, my name is Dave from the Plus Add-ons for Elementor, and today we are going to discover 5 different ways to get rid of spam emails in Elementor. Now, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel, as we upload 2 new Elementor videos each week, which will make you an Elementor master in no time. And also, please feel free to share this with your Facebook community so that all of your friends can learn more about Elementor. Very good. So let's get started. Okay, very good. So the very first step is to insert the form onto our page here. So we're going to look for form, and we're going to use the one that comes in by default with Elementor. So this one here, so just drag and drop it just like that. And as you can see, it comes by default with 3 different fields. We have the name, email address, and message. So feel free to add as many fields as required by using the form fields here by the side. You can add as many items as you wish. Just click on this and select either text, email, URL, etc., etc. So now let me show you how you can protect this form from receiving those annoying, pesky spam emails. And for this, we're going to look into our first method, which is the honeypot method. So for this, to add this to your form, very simply, as you can see, we add an extra field like this one here, going to the type. And now scroll down the options here, and as you can see, you have a honeypot here at the bottom. If you select this one now and click update, that's it. The honeypot method is in place. So how does the honeypot method work? Well, basically it works by adding a hidden field that's not visible to the human eye. So if your visitors go onto your website, they will not see it. But those bots that are crawling your website will see that field, and they will actually fill this with some information, and the form will be considered as spam. So it's a trap, basically, you know, and that form will not be submitted. So you will not receive those annoying spam emails using this method. Now, this is quite an old method, to be honest, but it will get rid of some bots. Now, obviously, as time goes by, the bots are getting more and more advanced, which leads us nicely to the next solution here, which is a maths question. So you can add basically a mathematical question here that you will have to answer. So for this, how do we do this? Very simply, we go back to our type here, and we're going to select number, okay? And for the label here, you're going to put the question that you want to ask. So something simple, you know, for instance, 4 + 3 equals something, you know? And there you go, and question mark maybe. So now they have to answer this question. So this is the question we have in place, 4 + 3 equals. And now we need the answer. How can you set the answer here? Very simple, you have the minimal value. So 4 + 3 equals 7. So we're going to select 7 here. This is the minimum value. And the maximum value, you can put the exact same value, which is 7. So this is the only acceptable answer, okay? And obviously we're going to make this field required. So this is a mandatory field, okay? Now if we update this, and let's have a look in the front end. Now let me show you how this one works. So there you go. As you can see, I've pre-filled the form already. And now all we have left is our challenge question here. 4 + 3 equals. Now let's give the wrong answer here. I'm going to say 3 and then send. And as you can see, it's not submitting the form. But we also get a tip here. As you can see, we get the value actually. My value must be 7. So this is not so much a math test here, obviously. It's just to make sure it is a human that's behind the screen and behind the keyboard, obviously, you know. So a bot will not read this and will not calculate the results. So this is how you can do so very easily by using a math challenge. Now, if you decide to use this method here, just make sure that you change the challenge question here every maybe once or twice a month, just to be on the safe side, okay? Now, our next method is probably the best method you can put in place, and that is to subscribe to the POSIMYTH Innovations channel. Now, I'm just kidding here. This is not our third method, but regardless, feel free to subscribe to our channel. Now, let's go back to our contact form. So our next method now is one of the most secure one, obviously foolproof method. This is the reCAPTCHA method. And again, this is one of the safest method, the most foolproof method, because this is from Google themselves, you know. To apply this to your form, all you have to do is click on type and select reCAPTCHA. And you have two different methods here, reCAPTCHA and reCAPTCHA V3. V3 being the latest version. So I would highly recommend you use this one. So I'll click on this. And immediately from here, as you can see, we are required to enter an API key. So where can you fetch that API key? How can you create and generate that API key? Very easily, let me show you. Just go to Google now and type in Google reCAPTCHA. And that's the very first result here on top, reCAPTCHA Google, you know? So click on this. And now we're going to click on V3 Admin Console. So let's give it a name first. There you go. Now we need to select the version of reCAPTCHA we want to use. So we said it was V3. And now we need to add our domain name. So for this, go back to your Elementor page, go to the web address here and select your domain name itself. So select the domain name on its own without the HTTPS and any trailing slash and just paste it right here, just like that. Okay. Now we need to accept the terms of service, take this and then click submit. And right here we have our API key, so the site key and then the secret key. Now we need to copy and paste them in the backend of our website. So to do so, let's go back to our WordPress dashboard here, and we're going to go to Elementor and the settings and then integration. And as you can see here, we have the reCAPTCHA and reCAPTCHA V3. So this is the section where we need to insert those two keys. So let's do so together. So let's copy this one and then paste. Let's do the same with the secret key, Control C and then Control V. Now, don't forget to scroll down the page at the very bottom and click Save Changes. There you go. Now those changes have taken place. And now we can go back to our Elementor page. As you can see, it says we have this message here. Now if we refresh, it will take effect. So let's refresh this together. And there you go. Now the message is gone, meaning that it is actually working. And again, this is one of the most foolproof methods available on the market because this is from Google themselves. Now, if you are not comfortable using Google services, there is another option that's also very reliable that we're going to show you now. So the next option is by installing a plugin called CleanTalk. So for this, we're going to Plugins, Add New. In the search box, look for CleanTalk, all in one word, just like this, okay? And this is the very first one, as you can see, Spam Protection. So just click Install and then activate it. Very good. As you can see, now it is already installed and we get a message here that says, please enter the access key in anti-spam CleanTalk plugin to enable spam protection. So all we have to do basically is to click on this blue button here and it will generate the key for us automatically. So let's click on this. There you go. So that's done. Now it's going to synchronize this with the cloud automatically. And that's it. We're all done already. Now don't forget to click save to save our changes. And that's it. Now you're good to go. That's all we have to do. And now your form will be automatically protected against spam emails. Very good. And last but not least, our final solution is by using Cloudflare. So this is the free version of Cloudflare that we are using here. And once you've registered online with them, you have to confirm the ownership of your website, your domain name, which we've done here. And as you can see here, you get a message like this. Great news. Cloudflare is now protecting your site. And thanks to Cloudflare, you can secure the whole website or specific pages. And for this, we go to Security. From here, we're going to select WAF. So WAF stands for Web Application Firewall. And as part of the free version, you get to set up to 5 active firewall rules. So let's go ahead with this. So create firewall rule. There you go. So let's create our first one. So let's give it a name, perhaps contact form page, and then we can set up our rule. So let's go ahead with this. And as you can select among all these different options. So the one we're going to select here is the URI full. So what does that one mean? It means that it is specifically one page, one specific page. So we are going to target the contact form page only. And this is where you use this feature, URI full, okay? So where is our value here? Well, we go back to our website here. This is our landing page, our contact page. So we select the full URL here, Control C, go back here, and then paste it here, okay? Just like that. So this is step number one, and then we need to select the type of action. So as you can see, you can select among a few different options here. You have blocks, and this is to block the traffic all together to that page. Then you have JS, challenge, and so on and so on. So basically, Cloudflare is a big company like Google, and they have their own script in place to block all these bots, etc., etc. So it's a very powerful firewall, obviously, you know. So once you have this set up here, you can actually deploy this, and then it will be in place just like this, okay? So now we can go back to our page and test it out. So let me show you how this works. And now we are going to open this URL in a different web browser altogether, and pay attention to the start of the loading page. As you can see, there you go, that's the DDoS protection from Cloudflare. And there you go, now we are accessing our page. And since we set the rule to only work with the contact page, if you try to access the home page, let's open this in a new private window. Let's do this together, there you go. And as you can see, the challenge is not showing for that page, it will only show up for the contact page. Now, bear in mind that once your IP has been tracked by Cloudflare, the challenge will not show up again. So if I refresh this page here, and let's resend this, as you can see, it didn't show up again at this stage. So if you want to test this feature, all you have to do is to use a private window altogether, as there'll be no cookies, etc., etc. So back to our firewall rules here. If we scroll down, as you can see, we have the JS challenge in place, but you can change this to something else. So let me show you here. So the first one is manage challenge, and this is the one that's recommended. So what's the difference between the two? Well, basically here it will work on a score basis, and depending on the type of request, Cloudflare will dynamically choose the appropriate type of challenge. So this could be showing a non-interactive challenge page, maybe present an invisible challenge, show a custom interactive challenge, or even a CAPTCHA challenge altogether. And this will be done automatically for you. So let's go ahead with this. Now let me show you the difference. So if we save this, now let's have a look in an incognito page. So let's paste our URL and let's hit enter. And as you can see, this is totally different again, you know. So it will depend basically on the score and the type of internet connection that you have and all that, and how Cloudflare themselves analyze the type of traffic coming into your website. So there you go. This is how you can protect your contact forms from those pesky, annoying spams. Now we are open to your suggestions. If your favorite feature is missing, then feel free to add it to our roadmap so that we can hear about your great ideas. And for this, simply go to roadmap.theplusaddons.com and from there submit your suggestions. And we'd like to thank you in advance for your help and support. Again, if you liked and learned something new in this video, feel free to share it with your friends and your Facebook communities, and make sure to hit the like and subscribe button so that YouTube knows that you loved this video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.